Hello everyone, welcome to activity 11. I'm Dr. Shweta. So it states about magical morning. It states that sometimes you have heard that सुबह अच्छी हुई तो दिन पूरा अच्छा जाएगा. आज पता नहीं किसका मुंह देखा है कि दिन इतना बुरा गया है. Similarly, it states that the morning, the start has to be right. If you have watched the video which I have posted before of R.A. Mahindra, he very beautifully says that it's our first psychological victory of the day from waking up to getting up. He says that it has to be right. First thoughts has to be right. Has to be best. It should be of prayer, of faith, of trust, whatever you like, in whatever way you like. You know prayers, it's okay, it's well and good. If you don't know prayers, at least you can say thank you or be grateful that you are alive and seeing a next day. He very beautifully gives an example that a child cries and the mother knows that he is hungry. Similarly, a child cries and the mother knows that a nappy has to be changed. A child cries and mother knows that his stomach is aching. Similarly, the child cries and the mother knows that he wants to sleep. No single word, just a cry can explain his mortal mother that what he wants. Similarly, the Almighty, you think he needs words to understand our gratitude towards him. If for a minute you wake up and your heart can beat and feel the gratitude of this day, that is more than enough. That is a big celebration of this day. So our first task for today is the instance you get up, say thank you to the Almighty that He has gifted you a day. And the second activity deals with staying positive or being positive throughout the day. It says that whatever you use throughout the day, whenever you touch anything, it's called Midas activity. So I've been knowing the story of Raja Midas, that whatever he used to touch, it used to turn into gold. Similarly, now you have the power of gratitude, the magic dust which you were carrying yesterday. Take it with you today, and whatever things you used for getting ready and for working, etc., etc., throw that dust upon every object and feel grateful and say thank you to everything you use today. Say for instance that getting a day full of positive thoughts is very difficult. I have many problems in my life and things like that. Look, take it this way. It's called law of redemption. That is, deals with the karmic correlation, that whatever you have done in your past life or this life. Say for instance, yesterday we talked about that if you feel grateful for things, they will come back to you, that energy will come back to you in a equal intensity or in 10 folds or 100 folds. So in law of redemption states that if you have done wrong to anybody, and that also energy will come equally or in 10 folds or 100 folds. So whatever bad you are facing today, deal it as if you have done something wrong. So today you are nullifying that particular account. For example, the epic states that in Mahabharata, there was a character called Bhishma. So he asked Krishna that I have done so good things throughout my life, so why I am in such a pain while I am dying? He was literally lying on so many different arrows before he was about to die. So Krishna mentions that close your eyes, I'll take you through the journey of your past lives. So he goes back till 100 lives and he see nothing. He is like, I have done everything right till the date. And he goes 101 life before, and he sees that he is as a child and he is taking an insect in his hand, and he is like putting pins inside that insect. So Krishna tells that 101 life before you have done it with the insect. Now it has multiplied and came to you today. So that needle has turned into arrows. So you are just